I think the biggest challenge that interventional radiology currently faces is probably having the manpower and the infrastructure to be able to deliver all of the services that interventional radiology can now provide. Interventional radiological therapies will require to see the patients beforehand, to be able to explain the procedures, their possible benefits, complications, alternative therapies, and as well as the infrastructure required to see the patients after the procedure and follow them up appropriately so we can have good evidence-based outcomes as to the therapies that we provide.
To establish a 24-hour, 7-days-a-week cover in your hospital means that you really have to have a good team. So there is, in my opinion, a minimum number of colleagues working together of 4 to 5 interventional radiologists who are really skilled. As of today, interventional radiology and radiology is playing a key role in terms of patient management. Radiology, because this is imaging and diagnosis, and interventional radiology is treatment. So ideally, interventional radiologists offer both from one hand. That means diagnosis first, CT imaging, MR imaging, ultrasound, and then there is the option that you directly treat the patient. So this is crucial for big hospitals that you have a good running interventional radiological department to treat your patients optimally.
Well, we are in a big hospital with more than 1,200 beds, with an emergency department which receives more than 400 people per day. And we have a group of 5 interventional radiologists for the body who work full-time in this job. There are the senior and the junior, but the service can be covered for all situations.
I don't believe there is one specific area that's more important for interventional radiologists to be clinically involved. They have to understand where their procedure fits into the whole management of the patient. They have to manage that patient before, during, and after their intervention. And they're part of a whole clinical team and clinically responsible.
I think before and after care is absolutely essential for the interventional radiologist managing the patient to achieve the very best results. You may have excellent technical skills and innovations, but if you can't marry that up with looking after the patient and their individual concerns, then you will not achieve the maximal benefit for the patient.
In order to support young IRs and provide them with a good training pathway, we have to make a good curriculum, which we have already, and integrate this IR curriculum into the radiology curriculum. So I think that the sooner they come into contact with the IR subspecialty of radiology, the better it is.
So during the lessons we make during the course in radiology, we provide a couple of hours dedicated to show them what interventional radiology is and what it can do in terms of therapy to the patients. Then when they want to enter into radiology and show the vocation to become interventional radiologists, interventional specialists, this doesn't mean that they will come out as a fully trained interventional radiologist, because in interventional radiology, as in radiology, as in medicine as a whole, training never ends during our professional lives.
CIRSE is emphasizing the clinical role of interventional radiologists, both in the curriculum, which is currently being revised. It's examined in the European Board of Interventional Radiology examinations so that they have to understand their role as a clinician. And I think it's repeating this message constantly at annual meetings, at our other meetings like ECIO, the schools of interventional radiology that we run. So we are putting the clinical aspect of interventional radiology in all our programs.